Good morning, everyone. I'll add a clip of me driving up this hill here after we're down the hill, but pretty much delivered to a private residence that runs a showroom out of their backyard. Gotta square off every corner. That's a narrow gate for a Super B anyway. Close, but I just clear it. Coming onto this driveway is tricky because that's a narrow road with a very narrow driveway. Now I'm not worried about rolling the trailer because it's empty. It's not as big of a deal, but the rear tires of that trailer is right on the edge of that driveway. With a full load, that is a tricky corner to make. Okay, can I fit in the center? Yeah, if I angle it right, I can fit in the center. I just have to wait till the road's clear. Could have gone maybe if I had hammer down right away. But there's red lights on both ends of this road, so traffic comes in a pattern. Couldn't quite tell if any of them were in my lane or not. So I'll just wait and make sure. Okay. Off to Glenmore Trail. Load there.
Continue on Highway 2A.
And then head back home. Delivery in Penticton and a delivery in, I don't know if it's at Oliver or Sawyers, I can't remember, but two drops. If everything goes perfectly, it's a tarp load, so it has to go perfectly for me to make it home tonight.
continue on Highway 2A.
So 23 minutes to get to my loading spot. And then, see, let it load. I told it to go home. 10 hours, 18 minutes. I have 11 hours, 11 and a half hours, but I have to load and tarp in basically an hour and 15 minutes. Yeah, that's tight. Lake Fraser Drive. Why not just take the boat, it's called the 22X? No, 202 here? I guess that'd be shorter. Go that way and then to Barlow. Oh, wait, hang on. If I wanted to exit, I probably need to do a turn there. Okay.
Whatever.
We'll go A Road. Yeah, if I had wanted to exit here, I would have had to be in that lane. Construction zones can be a little confusing. That was a good workout unloading this trailer. I kept running around moving dunnage. It took them an hour and 20 some minutes to unload. But he's got such a tight, tight yard, it is obviously a little difficult to do the unloading there. These people are all probably turning off over here somewhere. Let's go past them because they're all going way below the speed limit. Okay, not way below, but below the speed limit. Down these roads, I think. I might have. I've been in here enough that I might have gone down some of these roads. from McLeod. We want to get onto Barlow. And it's busy here. Definitely busy city traffic. I think I should have taken the exit. The other road would have been better. Everybody's moving though, so that's good. Oh yeah, you're exiting and you had to pass me first to exit. Or you just forgot to turn your signal light off. Oh boy, really? And then another one takes its place. Causing me to do hard brakes. Open the window, it's hot in here. Nothing like smoking the trailer brakes a little bit, right? Sucks doing that. Very easily. Oh, come on, really? I'm leaving space for a reason. I don't want to be in that lane yet. I take it back. I don't want to be there yet. Goes the people mover. Electric train. They really need to work on getting rid of traffic lights on main highways. Main arteries going through the city. I still don't want to be in that lane. is where the GPS comes in handy. So that'll put us on Deerfoot. Find my way to the chipper. More of this kind of driving, all pretty much be this kind of driving all the way to chipper. Load there, and then head back Highway 1 through the Rockies. Should be a good drive. Before that, so I'll edit one off-duty minute to the on-duty time. I can't edit drive time, but I can edit on-duty time. So I'll edit 1 minute of my on-duty time to off-duty time, and then I'll have the half-hour break in. Always just beautiful entering Banff this way. Love it. Is that a drizzle? It's a light drizzle. So we have about half an hour to spare to make it home today. Likely I have to fuel up today. Well, we filled up Golden yesterday? Nah, I probably don't have to fuel up today, so that's good. I will have to take in consideration DEF will be getting very low by then, though. So I will, if I know I can't make it to Osoyoos to fuel up, Oliver's got DEF. I'll have to make sure, if I can't make it to Oliver to fuel up DEF, I'll have to fuel up either in Kelowna or in Sikkimoose.
Okay, we'll keep that in mind. Because I would really like to get home today. That'd be kind of cool. This car drives really fast, really slow. Really fast, really slow. They passed me while I was doing speed limit. I got cruise control on, not changing my speed. It changes slightly going uphill and downhill, but overall, I'm not changing my speed. Is that a chip truck? A loaded chip truck? Yep, it's definitely loaded. I see the chips falling out. Spectacular. Absolutely beautiful. Gotta be careful today how much video shooting I do. I recorded 2.5 hours of video yesterday. So we'll keep doing some decent length videos, but I'm going to try to keep them to an hour. Heartburn. It's in the tums. single time. My eyes are just peeled on those mountains. Just such majestic beauty. Doesn't matter what weather you come through here, it is beautiful. I do have advantage over other trucks in the 110 kilometer speed limits a little quicker. Most trucks are chipped to 105. Mine is not. So at 110 kilometers, I'm 5 kilometers faster than everybody else. And as soon as the speed limit goes down to 90, I'm the slowest guy on the highway. They'll all pass me again eventually. Wedged right between two ridges. Two ridges of the, what would you call them? Two arms of the Rockies. First time I drove up this way, my personal vehicle. So surreal seeing this in person. see it. It's all kind of hidden in the trees. Record, I pretty much ignore those signs. They're the ones that say no retarder brakes or no engine brakes or no Jake brakes. Any of those signs that say avoid use or engine brake fine of $250, ignore them. Completely just ignore them. I would rather use my engine brakes than have my brakes overheat, wear out my brakes, and I don't have loud engine brakes. The engine brakes themselves have a muffler on them, so they're muffled engine brakes, so they're not super loud. Maybe someday I'll get fined for it, but I leave my engine brakes on all the time. Well, not in the winter. In the summer, they're just on. A little bit of a heavier sprinkle. Hikers. I think that lane's an exit only further down the road. Want to be over here. If you ever drive through this park and you intend to stop and go for a hike, don't take the bypass lane. You will get ticketed. Get the park pass. Banff National Park. up with you guys further down on the road, or else we will have hours of video again. be close, but I think we'll make it home. So when they four-lane this highway, I really wonder what's going to happen to these snow sheds. Rumor has they're going to blast this huge tunnel through the mountain, and we're no longer going to go to the Rogers Summit anymore. If that's the case, I hope they keep this as a byway, as a scenic byway, even if they close it in the winter, but in the summer have it as a scenic byway. Running out, hit the throttle. Nissan. I'm down to 1/4 of a tank. Fuel, I'm at half a tank. I've got 330 kilometers to go. Fuel will for sure, no problem, last till home. DEF, I'll have to decide in Kelowna if I want to top off there or not. Uphill, it's just like, just let off the throttle just a little bit, it'll slow it right down to 70. How are those rigs getting in there? The gate's closed. Are they turning off, driving in here and doing a U-turn? From over here? Maybe. guess that's what they're probably doing. Doing it from this end over here. If you guys are wondering why those artillery cannons are sitting around on Rogers Pass, two of them there at the museum, another one up ahead at the monument here, it's because those are used in the winter to blast shells up to the mountains and control the avalanches. Cannon sitting here. Now the military actually does training. Oh, with your log, military shoots shells up into the avalanche areas. Say thanks for watching. Oh, train tunnel? Apparently the longest in the world. Right here, Rogers Pass. Keep all the comments coming. Really enjoy reading them all. Keep those subscribers coming up. If you're new to the channel, hit that sub. I'm doing a huge giveaway when we get to 1,000 subscribers, so if you're interested in that, let me know. If you've already said you're interested in it, I've put you down on a list. The list is growing bigger for the giveaway. We'll do a live giveaway on a weekend while playing video games.